This is my second video on ARPA. ARPA stands for Automatic Radar Plotting Aids, and I'm hoping that you have seen my previous videos on the marine radar and my previous video on the ARPA as well. If not, then I've given the links to those videos in the description section below. Make sure that you watch all those videos to have a good understanding of the topic of marine radar and the ARPA. In today's video, I'll be talking about the ARPA again, but I'll be focusing on two topics. And the first one is the trial maneuver facility that you have available in the ARPA. And the second one is the track history facility that again is incorporated into the equipment. So let's get started. I'll start with the topic of trial maneuver because under the performance standards as prescribed by the IMO for the equipment of ARPA, an ARPA must be capable of simulating the effect of an on-ship maneuver on all the tracked targets without interfering with the updating of actual target information. So there has to be some form of a positive identification on the display whilst in trial maneuver. Usually a T or a trial is written on the radar PPI. That is the planned position indicator. So if I can explain this simply to you guys, the trial maneuver actually allows you to run a scenario where you may take an action and see how that action will play out with respect to avoiding collision with other ships. You are not actually taking that action, you are just conducting a trial, and that's where the word trial maneuver comes from. So the heading marker may be displaced if trailing a course alteration. Now you have to remember that in trial maneuver, the ARPA takes into account the own vessel's radius of turn and settling period. And now just have a look at this animation and then I can tell you the procedure that should be followed when using the facility of the trial maneuver. So you can see here how the heading marker itself gets displaced. And the letter T is displayed on the radar screen to show you and easily distinguish the normal operation, the actual scenario from a trial scenario. So the trial maneuver is just you trying to run a scenario where you try out what the result would be if you alter a ship's course or reduce a ship's speed in respect of keeping a safe distance from other ships or landmarks or safe navigation, but you're not actually doing so. So when using the trial maneuver, make sure that you observe true vector display of targets to get an idea of the traffic flow first in the vicinity, which is there. Like I said before, in trial maneuver, remember that ARPA takes into account its own, the own vessel's radius of turn as well as settling period. Then make sure you switch the display to relative vector and turn on the trial maneuver switch or button or whatever. And then try out course and or speed changes as necessary. So you can do both. You can see how the scenario would play out if you change the course or change the speed without actually changing the ship's course or speed. Then you can decide on a maneuver and then switch the trial maneuver off. So you decide on the maneuver based on, of course, the fact that a particular maneuver will ensure that your ship is safe at all times, whether it's collision avoidance, whether it's staying off a landmark, whether it's staying away from a cluster of fishing boats. So switch the trial maneuver off once you decide on a maneuver, and then once again, observe the true vector of the targets and then take your maneuvering action. One thing you have to remember here is make sure that you give some time when you switch on and switch off the trial maneuver for the vectors to be displaying the correct information. Manufacturers have developed different functions for trial maneuver as the standards are not very detailed. So there are some systems which allow for instantaneous maneuvers, while some allow for something called time to maneuver or TTM. Some ARPAs allow the operator to make allowance for ship's maneuvering characteristics and to do a second maneuver such as a resumption. A general rule with operators who use trial maneuver is that the facility does encourage small alteration of courses as the function works on finding the right course to fit a desired CPA or a closest point of approach. Alright, so you can see here how based on a trial maneuver you can actually work out the expected CPA from vessels, especially those vessels which are on a collision course or vessels which are nearby, and how your change of courses will affect your resultant CPA with the other vessels, even though they may not be on a direct risk of collision with you. I now move on to track history, because the ARPA must display on demand at least 4 equally time spaced past positions of a target. On the some of the radars, these are true past positions when in true motion presentations, and relative past positions in a relative motion. The Sperry Rescar radar only gives true past positions. So there are, depending on the kind of radar that you have, you may get true past positions, you may get true and relative past positions, and so on. And the past history is designed to assist the operator in detecting recent maneuvers of targets, and the spacing between the history dots can be selectable by the operator who is operating the equipment, or is adjusted automatically with the range scale. So if you can see in the diagram, it shows how a track history can show a turn and acceleration or deceleration of a target. Target trails or afterglow is a facility with the extracted video which allows the operator to view the past positions of the target. It helps you to track the target, and that is why it's called track history. It helps you to track the movement of the target, so you get an idea of the maybe a bold alteration that ship has made, or if it is making a series of small alterations, or if they are reducing only speed and not altering the course. So it is very similar to track history, but not as precise. So the operator can actually select different minutes of afterglow, which is displayed in a different screen color to the target track. Once again, target trails is used to detect the maneuvering of targets. Of the two facilities, the track history or dots is probably the most useful. So when I say two facilities, I'm talking about trial maneuvers and track history. So some people feel very comfortable with using the track history. You have to remember one thing here, that relative motion will always show you relative tracks and not true tracks. So be very careful of what kind of motion your vessel is operating, the radar is or ARPA is operating on, and then evaluate the information carefully. I think that's pretty much it. I'll try to keep these videos short and cover only one or two topics now. That's what has been suggested by a few of my subscribers here. So I'll see you soon with my next video for now.